you're passionate for what you love and you're serious about it. When you see our cameras at the show, then we want to talk about it. Fair weather fans need not apply. We seek nerds that are true.
For the one, the only Pixel 8!
Yeah! Sun proudly brings to you Connecticut GamerCon, hosted by the Angry Geek Show.
And no, it's oh, we're not hosted.
All right, Big Fedora Productions. But they invited us to come down and hang out and play video games. Yes, Mr. Mitch Halleck. If you don't know, now you know, suckers. Anyways, we're here at Connecticut GamerCon, Mohegan Sun, Uncasville, Connecticut. My God, it's 10 o'clock in the morning, and they've sold out two times already of Monsters. What's wrong with these people, Lou?
It's 10 o'clock in the morning. People are walking around here eating pizza. They got a Call of Duty tournament.
Look at that huge TV. I need that.
Agent 47 right over here.
Agent 47.
Agent 47 from Hitman.
By the way, I put out a hit on you. You're dead.
Look at Agent 47 from Hitman. You got the barcode in the back of your neck?
That was yesterday.
No, I heard you were part of the cosplay contest yesterday, yes. Right? What place did you come in? Did you win?
Not even.
Okay, we know why.
It's tough not having boobies.
Why Agent 47?
I'm already bald.
Yeah!
I just needed to lose the beard, which was the toughest part to commit to this costume.
Well,
losing the beard.
I'm going bald, so I'm growing the beard.
This isn't about you. You're not Agent 47. So, did you ever play any of the games?
I played all of them. Okay, all of them.
Okay, all right, so big thing. What did you think of the movies?
The movies, first one, great. Second one, it was action-packed, but I think it needed to be more about Agent 47. I'm feeling like this Katia Van Dees just came in and just stole the show. Ugh.
All right, now, did you play in any of the tournaments that were going on?
Not today.
Not today.
Not today.
Well, today's young. The day is
young. The day is young. Yeah. Go enter one of the tournaments.
Maybe.
All right, we're going to go hit the floor. We're going to go talk to some gamers.
I'm going to play Call of Duty.
You're not going to play Call of Duty. You stink at Call of Duty.
I got to go find my target.
You go find your target.
He's right here. I put him.
Anyway, let's go talk to some more gamers. Plus, we got some cosplayers here that are strictly video games.
Video games. I've seen the Assassin's Creed people. I've seen Mario. I've seen ones that I don't know at all because, like, see, some people I don't know if they're cosplaying.
I know. There's people that, we never know.
You gamers are weird.
Look at it. Now, it's look at it. We got a wrestling tournament going on. We've got Bejeweled tournaments. This is awesome. First ever.
Mist over there? I think that might be.
Maybe. You got Marvel vs. Capcom over here.
Like, holy moly.
Let's go check out some of these games, and we'll be right back.
at Mohegan Sun.
There's a Pokemon tournament going on in
Pokemon.
The back. Well, we try to adjust
not
our camera.
And they're Pokemons.
That's what I just said, a
no,
Pokemon.
They're
pocket monsters. That's what Pokemon means. What do you know about Pokemon?
What do I know?
Pikachu. You know nothing. Anyway, there's a tournament.
I know Bulbasaur. I know Meowth. I know Mewtwo.
You have Bulbasaurs.
I know.
Anyway.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're here today at the GamerCon of Connecticut. Now, as you can see up on screen, nothing is happening.
There's a Pokemon tournament going on.
We have Garchomp versus Pikachu. Garchomp is the evolved version of.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Anyway, this is pretty cool. They have a Call of Duty tournament coming on, like we talked about earlier.
Yeah.
Now we got a Pokemon. Did you know Pokemon meant pocket monster?
I did. I said that a little while ago.
No, you didn't. Anyhow, this is pretty cool. We got Microsoft is here in the house. Nintendo was in the house yesterday. This is pretty cool.
This is. Look, here comes one of the guys. He's going to push you out of the way. He's like, I got a tournament going on. Move.
No, he's running tournaments. This is pretty crazy. Let's.
Welcome to the Angry Geek Show.
Yeah, there's a gamer. You didn't even get a camera. Wow, look at that. Look
he's
at that.
A little man.
I think we should talk. I think we should talk to some gamers. What do you think?
No. Why? Because they all smell funny.
But you smell funny.
No, that's the gamers.
Right. Let's take a break and we'll be right back.
I swear I left my medicine at home. Did you lose to a girl? All right, Jeremy Courtney, I'm back here at Connecticut GamerCon at Mohegan Sun.
Come over here. You're going to have to lift her up.
I don't know.
Because he's 8 feet tall.
All right, look at. Oh, he's got her.
All right. She's in there. All right. Connecticut GamerCon here at Mohegan Sun, checking out the free games. And there's a little person that just whooped her dad's butt in MotoGP.
Really? You beat your dad in that game. Yes, you did.
Say
you
yes.
did? You're dead?
All right, hold on.
So, what was it like to beat your dad in the game?
That was really fun.
Oh, Mr. Harry.
Yeah.
Come on, Simone, say hi.
Yoda came.
Well, you.
He's right here. Yoda.
I know it's Yoda.
Okay, come on over here.
Anyway, is this your guys' first time at a. Is this your guys' first time at a convention or any?
Yes.
Yes.
How old are you?
10.
10 years old. How old are you?
9.
9 years old is he beat her. You play video games?
Yes.
Game to camera. You what games do you play?
I play Minecraft.
Heyday.
Heyday. That's it.
Do you play games?
No. Drive the motorcycle.
All right, so is this your first time coming to any type of convention?
Yes.
Really? This is our first time covering a gamer convention. We usually do Comic Cons, but.
Yeah, we're nerds. We're geeks. I guess
that's what your shirt says, Angry Geeks.
I'm not angry, though.
No, not today. Not today. So what was it like getting beat by her? We watched you. We were setting up the cameras, and we saw you.
It's all right. She can beat me any day.
Any day? All right. So you guys are going to go out and have some fun? You going to enter any of the tournaments?
Probably.
What tournament?
Hopefully Call of Duty.
Yeah. All right. You go play Call of Duty. You have some fun. Go play Payday. You keep beating your dad.
Okay.
All right. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back.
Bye.
Well, after that last interview with Jeremy, of course, I had to take over. I'm here with Skinwalker Studios and Jason Rosen. We're still here at Connecticut GamerCon. Jason, what's going on, man? You got some impressive work. The artwork is fantastic. I love horror stuff. Very Swamp Thing-esque. What's going on?
Well, we're here to promote our project Monster Wood. It's a project we've been working on for quite a while now. So we're pleased to finally have it here and roll it out. We were very fortunate in that we had a successful Kickstarter campaign a few years back that allowed us to finish up book number one. So it's the first book out of a three-book series. So this is kind of like the first act out of a three-act dramatic structure. It's based on our screenplay that I
co-wrote. Oh, screenplay, really?
Oh, yeah.
But a scoop? Is this a scoop?
This is the scoop. So the thing is that, you know, a lot of people, I understand, like, you know, they're writing a screenplay or whatever, but I knew that I had to make this the best because it's a crowded, very competitive field. So I joined with my friend Louise Gickow. She's ex-head writer for Disney, ex-head writer for Jim Henson Productions. She's a multi-Emmy winning writer. So I knew that she could really maximize the potential that we had in Monsterwood, and we've done just that. And then we took the screenplay and we broke the screenplay down into the three acts, and that's how we're adapting into the graphic novel. I was fortunate enough that I'm friends with Steve Ellis. He's worked for Dungeons & Dragons, Magic the Gathering, Marvel, DC, AMC Television, and we've been working to adapt that screenplay into this graphic novel. So this is our first book. Steve's amazing. He's great to work with. And of course, his work is very well known. So we're psyched to have it here. I mean, we see it as a true transmedia property. You know, we have the graphic novel covered. We're looking forward to books two and three. And of course, there's endless possibilities. You know, this banner here has more cinematic imagery. And that was done with my friend Paul Girard, who's one of the bigger concept design guys out there. He's done Wrath of Titans, Clash of Titans, Shannara Chronicles, seasons one and two, Outsiders. And even down to some of the character designs with Paul Komoda, who just worked on Kong Skull Island and the new Alien movie. So we've kind of got it all. You know, we hit with the collectibles. No, that's a hand.
Look at this. This is pretty. This is badass.
We have our action figure prototype done in the classic 3¾ scale Star Wars figures, old school, baby. We're trying to get into some of the collectible market, because I love to collect stuff like that, Lord of the Rings, Sideshow, all that stuff. So we have Zumari, who's one of the foot soldiers of the bad guy, Tiberius. And then this one just came out of the mold yesterday, just got here for the show. This is our main character, Jovis. So this will be the next bust that we have coming out. And all of this stuff can be seen on skinwalkerstudios.com, but of course, the coolest place to be is right here at GamerCon.
How is GamerCon treating you?
Oh, it's fantastic. We've met so many great folks. We've sold a lot of books, so we're really happy. I mean, this is definitely the place to be.
When we were walking through, not to name drop, but the promoter, Mitch Halleck, when he was walking us through GamerCon, he was like, "Dude, I saw somebody out in the lobby reading your book last night. That must have made you feel absolutely wonderful."
Absolutely. You know, it's like you work on something like this because it's what you love to do and you have a story to tell. But, you know, past getting it across the finish line, you have no control over how people react to it. So when you see people and they're really excited about it and the first question out of their mouth is, "When's book two coming?" That's like the best feeling in the world. Here.
Where did the story come from? Now, my coolest thing is I always wanted to have someone say, "I had a dream. I woke up. I wrote it down." Where did this story come from?
This story has been kind of unfolding slowly over years and years. My oldest son, who is now 21, the impetus really started with him. And when he was born, I was doing that first-time parent thing and thinking, who are you? Where did you come from? Why are you here? And if that's not the basis of character development, I don't know what he is. So, you know, he was really the impetus for the central character, Jovis. And then the world and the stories kind of evolved around that. But really, I guess in a nutshell, it's my love letter back to all the stuff that I grew up on, the 70s and 80s, right? So
same era as me.
Right, exactly. So, and that was, you know, back in the dark ages when comics and all the movie culture, that was kind of a subculture. It wasn't as mainstream as it is today. So it's tremendous to see it kind of evolve to what it is. So like I said, this is my love letter back to all of that stuff. I mean, I would say it's kind of like Lord of the Rings meets Jungle Book, as disparate as that may sound, but in the telling, it's very original, you know what I mean? So it feels familiar, but it's fresh, and I think it's really reflective of the time that we're in, you know? I mean, it's really about a male, you know, like a young teenage boy and a teenage girl. They're from completely separate walks of life, and of course, like most teenagers, they know it all, and they have it all figured out, so they're gonna leave home while they still have all the answers, and just by chance they run into each other and they discover that their reality, their worldview, is a complete lie. And if that's the case, then what is reality? And then when they find out the shocking truth of the reality of their world, they have to figure out what they're going to do about it. So if that doesn't sound like modern day, I don't know what
that is. Modern day. All right, a question. Movie's going to be made. Do you want it to be live action, or do you want it to be animated, or do you want it to be CGI animated? What's your preference to bring this to life? Live action, strictly animated, kind of like Fire and Ice, or do you want it CGI like Pixar?
I think it could go any one of those modalities, really, depending on who is handling it. But if in my dreamland, absolutely, it's live action done with bodysuits, modern animatronics. I mean, that old school technology is not old school. Like, those new animatronics can blink as fast as you and I can blink. So it's completely realistic. I absolutely love the way Guillermo del Toro makes his films, where he blends everything, where he blends state-of-the-art prosthetics, and he also augments with CGI and then uses that for set extension. You know what I mean? So whatever works best for the shot, but I want it all to be seamless. I hate when I'm taken out of a film because that piece of CGI just sticks out when they could have done it so much better with a physical suit.
That was my next question. Dream director to bring your project to life, and I think you just answered that. But just in case you didn't, dream director of bringing that project to life would be?
I would say Guillermo del Toro to produce, if not direct. I mean, there's many talented directors, but I think with his eye, his love of fairy tale aesthetic, and just his knowledge of storytelling in general, he would be the perfect person to make sure that we really capitalize on all the unique possibility that this has.
You hear that, Twitter? Skinwalker Studios, Jason Rosen, Lewis Perry from the Angry Geek Show and the Earplug Podcast Network. We're here at Connecticut GamerCon. Check them out online. See ya.
And welcome back to the Angry Geek Show here in Uncasville, Connecticut at Mohegan Sun at Connecticut GamerCon. I am with Peter Hoy, and he's with Black and White Gaming. Peter, tell us, VR.
VR. So we're Black and White Gaming. My name is Peter. You can see back there my buddy Devon. Basically, what we do is we make a lot of virtual reality content. What we do is we take virtual reality games, make a little fun video for people to watch, upload it to YouTube, and we're just a small channel hoping to start out. But today we thought it'd be fun to bring the VR that we use, let people try it out, let people test things. We've gotten a preview build of Cyber Drifter by Uzi Games, unreleased. First time it's being shown is here at this GamerCon. And they're looking for feedback, so we're just asking anybody that comes through, you know, what do they think of the game? What do they think of the channel? Please follow us. Let us know what you like.
What's the channel?
The channel is Black and White Gaming.
See, I already got that. I already got Black C. Bam! Now, your favorite VR game.
So right now, my favorite VR game, it's a mixture of two. All right? Shooter Zombie, Arizona Sunshine. If you have a Vive, try it out. It's amazing. Horror, A Chair in a Room. Easily one of the best mind-blowing stories I've played, and it's a fully immersive experience inside the virtual reality headset.
I have a chair in my room.
I love
it. Be great.
I love a chair in my room.
Yeah, right? Sit down, it's kind of good. You know, you're just like, it's scary. All right, so what got you guys into this? Like, we got to do VR and, like, promote this stuff and, like, get out there. What happened?
So I'm a huge gamer, but I like people.
We train together. Anyway.
but you know, after a long day, I get home sometimes and I just want to sit there and zone out to someone. I love gaming, so I'll sit there, I'll watch a YouTube personality. Mm-hmm. I'll zone out, I'll enjoy them. They'll tell a couple jokes, I'll laugh, and it's good. We want to be that for other people, and we want to use this, you know, to elevate to other things. Like, we raise money for Extra Life.
Oh, hey, yeah. The gaming thing.
Yes.
There, where you play video games, you raise money, and, like, people benefit from it.
Absolutely.
Weird.
Yep. So we do that.
Gaming.
We want a game to help people. That's what it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the Angry Geeks proudly brings to you Black and White Gaming. Boxing sensation Lewis Perry versus the air.
He's getting suited up. This fight, we have been waiting for this fight for 20 years. I tell you folks, we are in for a sensational night of boxing here tonight. Now is the challenger, Lewis "The Rock" Perry, comes into the area. His coach is getting him all ready. He's about ready to put on the gloves. He's gonna put on the gloves now. He's putting them on. Now, as we all know, Lewis Perry came from the humble beginnings, growing up in Connecticut, working at the Dream Factory for 40,000 years. This is his first professional fight, and it's for the world championship. He's having trouble turning around. As we see, this is probably not going to end well for the challenger, Lewis Perry. Now, coming into the ring with Mr. Perry will be the one, the only, Rocky Balboa. The man, the myth, the compulsive master. Oh, he's already getting lit up. Oh, it looks like he's in there. He's trying to box. Oh my God, that was a backhand. You do not backhand in boxing, folks. This guy, oh, he's not even giving him a breather. Oh, another block, he's blocking. Oh, he knocked him down, folks. He knocked him down. The champion is down right now. Oh, but he's getting back up. He's shaking it off. Oh, they're going back at it, folks. All right, a left, a left, a right, a right, a right, a right, a right. My God, it's like watching two girls box. This is ridiculous. The man, his trainer pulling him back. Uh-oh. Yeah, bite him in the ear. Oh, man. Oh, he dinged him in the chin with that one. Oh, he's blocking. Oh, he's got him down on the ground again. 2, 3, 4, 5. The champ's getting back up. He's shaking out the cobwebs. Oh, and now it's back on. A left, a right, a right, a left, a right, a left. Did he just backhand him? I don't even know if that's right. There's a block. Somebody, does he know he's supposed to be punching, not smacking? My God. Oh, there was an uppercut there, I think. I don't know. Was that a couple of jabs? Oh, he took him down again, folks. That's a TKO. TKO. It's over, folks. The challenger, Lewis "The Rock" Perry, has won it. Angry Geek Show.
That was badass.
I'm gonna race Jeremy. We're gonna see which one of them angry geeks are better. I'm gonna put him in the wall.
I got a mustache. Where are we going?
New York.
What's this?
Yes.
that you were driving. Ready?
This has been a Fanboys Incorporated Network production. Found on fanboysinc.com, iTunes, and Stitcher Radio. Good night and geek on.